at the end of World War II, the US Army was using the 75mm M6 gun armed M24 Chaffee light tank, an otherwise satisfactory and reliable light tank. Nonetheless, by 1949, the US Army had decided to replace it, leading to the T-41E1, which was eventually type classified as the M41. Fitted with the more powerful M32 76mm main gun, gun stabilization and a rangefinder, the M41 marked a step change in the firepower of light tanks for US forces. Weighing just 23.5 tons, the M41, powered by a Continental or Lycoming boxer six-cylinder engine delivering 500 horsepower, was an agile tank with excellent firepower for its weight. Widely exported, it saw decades of use in dozens of armies around the world, but by the 1990s was seriously obsolete. Inadequate fire control system, no laser rangefinder, and a gun incapable of tackling even second-line Soviet tanks meant the M41 had had its day. Like other light tanks of World War II or post-World War II era, it was simply not able to offer a modern army what it needed in terms of firepower. Whereas particularly Western armies could afford the development of a new era of light, capable, and well-armed platforms offering increased protection, second-rate armies could not. Many armies around the world were still operating or had vehicles like the M41 or AMX-13 in stock, or were looking to perhaps add some capability to their armored force by adding a turret to an APC like the M113. The Belgian firm of Cockerill, with a very long history of development and manufacture, offered exactly this option in the early 1990s in the form of a light turret with a new powerful 90mm gun, offering performance similar to the well-regarded Royal Ordnance 105mm gun, but without the weight. This option, therefore, potentially allowed more cash-strapped militaries to upgrade otherwise obsolete vehicles to modern firepower standards, or to add much-needed firepower to an APC or wheeled platform. For the purpose of tests and to potentially elicit sales, this new turret, known as the LCTS, was mounted on a surplus M41 Walker Bulldog, presumably from surplus Belgian stocks, as the Belgian army had operated 135 of them between 1958 and 1974. Despite the potential benefits on offer, this turret did not find any interest in itself, but its descendants are currently in service with the US Army and other forces around the world. The M41 light tank was of a conventional layout, with the driver in the front, crew space in the central part, and engine in the rear. The turret was mounted roughly centrally on the vehicle, and the new LCTS turret was mounted in exactly the same place as the original. The available photograph clearly shows the use of a turret ring adapter mounted on the hull to match the new turret. Only a single crew member was used in the hull of the M41 light tank, and this crew member, the driver, was obviously retained for this demonstrator vehicle too. Sat in the front left of the hull, the driver, his controls, hatches, optics, etc., would remain unchanged from the M41 or other platforms on which the turret could be placed, notwithstanding any additional upgrading done at the same time as adding the turret. The previous crew complement of the M41 consisted of 3 more men, with the commander, gunner, and loader in the turret. But for this vehicle, that original turret was completely removed, and so were these crew positions. Inside the new turret was space for just 2 crew, seated roughly side by side. The first, the commander, sat on the left of the turret under a single-piece hatch. He was provided with a single forward-facing sight for the primary weapon and had 5 periscopes around his hatch for observations. Any additional sights, including a thermal sight, were presumably available as aftermarket options for potential buyers. The second crew member in the turret was the gunner, and he sat on the right of the turret, also with a single one-piece hatch. He too had a single primary forward-facing sight for the main gun and an array of 5 periscopes around his hatch for all-round observations. With no loader in the turret, the gunner would have to fulfill this function too, but it allowed for a substantially smaller turret as well, which was a substantial size and weight trade-off for a reduced rate of fire available. The M41 tank used a 6-cylinder boxer-type petrol engine from either Continental or Lycoming, the AOS 895-3, delivering 500 horsepower at 2,800 RPM. This allowed a 23.5-ton tank to reach speeds of up to 72 km per hour on a road. Later versions of the M41, the M41A1 and M41A2, used the fuel-injected version of this engine, the AOSI-895-5. Suspension was provided by means of 5 double road wheels with rubber tires and 3 rubber-tired return rollers, all running on tracks 533mm wide. The CD500-3 cross-drive transmission was at the back, driving the sprocket to move the tracks, and a singular idler wheel was located at the front. There is no information in Jane's, from Cockerill, or from the photograph of the vehicle available to suggest any changes to the hull used. Any upgrade program from a buyer may obviously have included upgrades to whatever power plant or drive desired. The available photograph of the vehicle from Jane's does show some reel on the back deck of the hull, but this does not appear to have any relevance to the design or automotive elements. The turret was the whole point of the design. Able to be fitted to a variety of hulls, it was only fitted to the chassis of an M41 light tank for demonstration purposes. Using this hull was a clear sign of the potential market for a turret which could modernize an existing light tank, such as the M41 or AMX-13, which were still in widespread international service, but which were otherwise obsolete. Adding this turret would offer potential clients a relatively cost-effective way to make an old platform into a capable modern vehicle without the expenditure needed to develop or purchase a completely new vehicle. The LCTS turret was fitted with a pair of 7.62mm machine guns of a type not specified, as these would be changeable by the client. One of the machine guns was fitted coaxially with the main gun, and the other would be mounted on the roof of the turret for anti-aircraft protection. Up to 750 rounds of 7.62mm ammunition could be carried in the turret. The main armament, however, was not changeable like the machine guns, as it was inherent to the design. Consisting of the 90mm Cockerill Mark 7 gun, this was mounted centrally in the narrow front of the turret. The gun was able to be rotated a full 360 degrees and was capable of minus 9 to plus 20 degrees of vertical movement. Turret traverse was powered and the speed of rotation was 30 degrees per second. This meant it would take 12 seconds to make a single full 360 degree revolution. Two banks of smoke grenades were carried on each side of the turret. 8 additional grenades were carried inside the turret. Up to 12 rounds of 90mm ammunition could be carried in the turret, as well as some additional rounds in the hull of the tank, although this would depend on what the donor hull being used would be. For example, mounting the turret on an M113 would allow significantly more potential stowage than on an AMX-13 hull, so the exact stowage could not be determined. It is worth noting that the gun and turret, during various iterations, were trialed for several vehicles, including the British Saladin armored car at one point. Stowage on the M41 for its original 76mm gun was 57 rounds, with 13 in the turret, 11 in a ready rack, and 33 in the hull. For this new smaller turret, just 12 90mm rounds were able to be carried in the turret, and assuming a substantially smaller or no space for a ready rack, this would still leave hull stowage for 30 rounds in the hull. In total, therefore, perhaps around 40 to 50 rounds could be stowed using this turret on a modified M41. The 90mm Cockerill gun, launched in around 1982, went through various stages of development. The Mark 7 was a modification of the Mark 6 and was itself modified and replaced by the Mark 8 in 1992. Weighing less than 3/4 of a ton and with a length of 4.365 meters, the 90mm Cockerill operated at a pressure of just 310 megapascals and produced a recoil stroke of just 350 to 370 millimeters. Ammunition for the Cockerill gun was made by Mekar and included a potent armor-piercing fin-stabilized discarding sabre tracer round with a muzzle velocity of 1,500 meters per second, able to defeat NATO triple-heavy targets, a high-explosive plastic round to defeat bunkers, structures, light armor, and also for indirect fire use, as well as smoke, canister, high-explosive anti-tank, and training rounds. The hull armor for the M41, as would be expected from a light tank, was poor, with just 30mm at 40 degrees on the front, 25mm on the sides, and 20mm at 40 degrees on the rear. The new LCTS turret was basic and based on a simple welded steel shell. The basic shell provided protection from small arms fire, and could, if required, be supplemented with some additional layers bolted to the exterior to increase protection. This would also increase the weight from 2,400 kilograms, and the ballistic protection improvements would not be sufficient to resist enemy tank fire, and would only go as far as providing protection from heavy machine gun fire. More than that would be somewhat pointless, given that the prospective vehicle on which this would be mounted was relatively lightly armored too. The LCTS turret was similar in size to the ACEC AK-90E turret, as fitted to the ACEC Cobra a few years prior. It too mounted a 90mm gun and seated the two crew side by side. The AK-90E turret was larger though, weighing some 200 kilograms more and able to stow 17 more 19mm shells than the LCTS. Given that both firms are Belgian and offered these very similar turrets just a few years apart, it is hard not to see the LCTS as a direct development from the AK-90E, both on a pure visual comparison but also based on the technical specifications of the two. The LCTS, as shown, received no orders. It was undoubtedly a capable platform on which to mount the very capable 90mm Cockerel gun, and combined with some modern fire control and ranging would have provided a serious way to upgrade otherwise obsolete vehicles to a modern standard. Despite the lack of sales, Cockerel continued their development and refining, and the descendant design of the LCTS 90mm is the LCTS 90MP, a highly successful turret with a 90mm gun in service, amongst others, with the US Army. That's all for this video. Make sure to follow our website, we'll be releasing new articles on the regular. You can follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, or Reddit, and if you use Discord, there's a link to our community server in the description. Also, likes, comments, and subscriptions on YouTube are greatly appreciated. If you would like to help us continue to develop and expand, also consider donating on Patreon or PayPal. All of the funds will be used to help us enhance and design new articles and features for you. Until next time, keep us in your sights.